Let's get updates from the PPCRV's command center at the Pope Pius in Manila now. Maiki Oreta is there. Maiki.
Hi, Pinky and Ron. The atmosphere here is calm and the people are collected, but the pace here is expected to pick up in the hours ahead, especially after 7 p.m. tonight, when the first batch of electronically transmitted election returns start coming in. Now, between now and then, the PPCRV has been busy fielding calls from their hotline. Some of these are very serious in nature. Joining me right now is Anna Singson, the media and communications head of the PPCRV. Anna, how has the morning been for you? The complaints coming in have been very great.
Yes, it's been very busy for us. We've been fielding calls since 7 o'clock in the morning. In fact, since last night, midnight, we're already taking calls from our coordinators. This morning, there were a lot of calls regarding PICO's machines breaking down in Noveliches, in Marikina, in areas of Batangas, and even in Baguio. But the good thing is that as of 10 this morning, many of them had been resolved. So we're very encouraged by the fact that while there were issues, they're being resolved. So there are solutions being found to them. Most lately, we had reports, and this one from Attorney Calieja, a lawyer, reporting all the way from Mindanao, saying that the votes, the ballots in Sabarongis, in Baroques, and in Dato Sinusat are actually already pre-shaded and are actually in one residence being shaded already, and that the election officers in these areas cannot be found. The lawyers are trying to find them, and our PPCRV coordinators are trying to find these election officers as well.
This is a very serious concern.
This is a serious
matter for the PNP to address already.
Yes. In fact, what we're doing is, after we get the report, is we field it to the different areas. We escalate to COMELEC the issues on the PICO's machines. We field to the PNP issues such as this one that is happening in ARM. And we also field to our PPCRV coordinators' queries with regards to the conduct of the elections.
Mm-hmm. With regards to the other updates, you said that members of the BEI are giving sample ballots or pre-shaded ballots. This is in Santa Ines, Mabalacat, Pampanga.
Yes.
And in Taguig precincts, their members of the Nacionalista Party there are taking pictures of the ballots in violation of...
That's a direct violation of the law. The ballots are sacrosanct. They are secret. That's why you have ballot secrecy folders. Nobody is supposed to take a picture of your ballot because that could be related to vote buying. Nobody is supposed to see who you're voting. That is secret and that is sacred. So do not allow anyone to do that. As for the reports of the BEIs, unfortunately, sadly, it is verified because we verified this with our coordinators. For the BEIs, you are not supposed to be giving out sample ballots. You are supposed to be the most nonpartisan of all the election officers because you're right there in the precinct. So please, keep your nonpartisanship.
Well, it helps that you're telling us this now so that the authorities can get a handle on the situation and actually act on it. Apart from this, how has the first half been of the election?
Well, I'm comparing it to 2010. Pretty much the same thing. Issues in the morning, because it's technically oriented, because it's machine-based, there really are issues with machines bogging down. Now, I will start getting really concerned if these issues are not addressed by 11, 12 o'clock, and if we still start hearing things like this in the afternoon. That means that resolution is slow. However, we are, as I mentioned earlier, a while ago, we're quite encouraged by the fact that a lot of the PICO's areas, at least in Batangas, a lot in Noveliches, Marikina, and some in Quezon City, and even in Baguio and Antipolo, have called to say that their issues were addressed by the IT officials of COMELEC. So that's a good thing.
Mm-hmm. Going back to Election Day of 2010, by 7:16 p.m., you had the results of 987 precincts.
We did.
Or 1.29% of all precincts. Given that it's the second time for the country to use the automated process, do you expect things to be quicker this time around? If so, by how much?
I think it will probably be roughly the same because you're still going through the same transmission lines, through the same transmission media as we were before. So we had 80% of all the transmitted votes in by within the first 12 hours. So at 7 a.m. of the next day of the elections in 2010, we already had 80%. Unfortunately, that speed was not duplicated for the balance of 20%. The balance of 20% in 2010 came in a very slow crawl. So slow, in fact, that we were here receiving transmissions until 2 or 3 weeks after until 2 weeks after the elections.
Okay.
So we're hoping that it's not that slow this time. And one of the major concerns that we also raised to COMELEC was that in 2010, we only received 92% of the transmissions. We in PPCRV and the rest in media also, because all of us are connected to the 8%. Same server, we were blind to that 8%, and that 8% was a very definitive differential. So what we're saying is it should be 100% transmission this time, and if not, they should give us access to that data so we can add it up to whatever transmissions we have.
Okay. Now, speaking of the process for the electronically transmitted returns, so the PCOS machines count the ballots.
Yes.
The canvassing or consolidation systems or CCSs tabulate the figures from all the PCOS machines.
Yes.
Then the results are sent to the Comlec central server. From
yes.
then, what happens?
First, each PCOS machine will transmit the data to three areas. First, to the municipality, at the municipality level. Second, to the central server. Third, to the transparency server. The transparency server is Comelec server, which is located here in PPCRV. And the law mandates that there are four groups who are entitled to be connected to that transparency server. The four groups are the leading majority party, the leading minority party, KBP, and the leading citizens arm, which is PPCRV. So there are four of us connected by law to that particular server.
All right.
Now, that data, we get that. It's connected to our own server, so we can make our own tabulations and consolidations, and we're supposed to make our own analysis, which we will start showing as soon as the transmissions come in. We're anticipating that anywhere between 10 to 15 minutes within the closing of elections,
okay.
we should get some data coming in already.
All right. Thank you. Thank you for
Thank
your time.
You.
I know it's
Thank
been
you.
A very busy morning for you.
For all of us. For all of us.
Anna Singson, the
Thank
Media
you.
And Communications Director of the PPCRV. And that's it for now. Back to you guys at the studio.
Thanks a lot.